teams square off and do battle. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calorie. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He'll take it from the two. And he's tackled at the 21. NC State's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively. But when you've got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the cause.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups. And when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup. And if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
You talk about a dual threat guy, this guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Looking for the corner. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Going deep, lays it out there. And he hauls it in deep downfield. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A four-play, 78-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. The ball for a nice game.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Got a man. Watch out here. And he's tackled at the 39-yard line. Good pitch and catch there on 2nd down.
Yep. It was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
He fights forward to about the 39.
No gain on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
No gain. That brings us up to 10.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. 3 yards there on the play.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. NC State's offense deserves all the credit in the world. You come into a crowd like this, and they didn't keep them from doing the job at hand. They got points on that opening march.
Just really impressive. Considering this is, I think, one of the toughest environments in all of college football, that's a job well done. Now they've got to continue to try to build off of that opening drive.
He's got it with room to run. Steps out of bounds at the 46. North Carolina State is up 7.
Thunder! nice gain.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
From their own 48-yard line, third down. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on him. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
And he's taken down right around the 26-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
And he throws it away. And here's another third down. And down he goes at the 16-yard line. The 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
North Carolina State is up a score. They'll bring him down at about the 3-yard line. Outside the goal line.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
So they're going to go for it here. Touchdown, Wolfpack.
That is great, tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Quickly incomplete. Third down, six to go. Ball on the 29. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. And
he's taken down at the 37.
NC State's offense is really looking dangerous so far in this one, Kirk. I mean, what's the defense going to do to slow them down?
I think you have to start somewhere, and that somewhere, I think, is stopping the run. You have to load up, take your chances, put extra numbers in the box. Once you stop the run, then it can allow you to put some pressure on the passing game. Right now, they're not stopping the run or the pass.
They'll work the left. He's taken down at the 36-yard line.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. Try running left. He's at the 30. And they make the stop at about the 15-yard line.
That's a D-32.
Double tight, double tight.
That makes it first and 10.
Mike 12.
We played one quarter. North Carolina State in front, 14-0.
We're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
From the 17-yard line, second down. Another carry. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. He's in trouble, and he tackles him hard at the 24. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he just drilled it from long range.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
17-0, North Carolina State. He'll return it from the one. Gets out to about the 21.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Here's the halfback. Nice gain as he works the right side. Down at about the 39-yard line. Tackle at about the 45.
That'll make it second and four.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 19 was
there. They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
That'll bring up third and four.
Check downs up there. Four down. 43 is the fight.
Damn.
Motion.
New seven.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. Slings it. He goes out of bounds at the 34.
The pass results in a first down.
I'll tell you, great call by the coaches on first down. It stretches the defense when they're expecting the run, and then they end up with another first down.
Fires to his tight end, nothing doing. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. And he hits him hard at the 26.
This is a big first down for this offense. I think it's another good example about how important it is to have an awareness about you as a wide receiver. Wide receiver did a really good job of knowing exactly where the first down marker was, and he made sure to get the route at least to that point, so when he made the catch and got hit, he had the first down.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
So the offensive coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the fifth first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Touchdown, Tigers! A short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
And he adds the extra point. So a 12-play, 80-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That'll make it second and four.
And they'll run him again.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Third down and seven. Ball on the 28-yard line. With a run, and he's going to be stopped short. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Just a great job by the defense. These guys are disguising their defense so well that they're confusing the quarterback and the offensive line.
They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And he's tackled at the 43.
Number 95 on the tackle at the 43-yard line. That makes it second and eight.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down right around midfield. And he's stopped behind the line.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. The blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. NC State's put themselves in a great position now as they head into the second half.
Well, in the first half, we saw a lot of big playability and just a lot of just an explosive approach by this offense. But remember, we'll see what happens here in the second half. This is a long way from being over.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook.
And he's going to come up with a sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 18. And they got it.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
The defense punches them off the field after just three plays.
That was a short round, Brad. Nothing seems to be working right now.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. So they're just about set to get the game going again.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Going deep. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. Wow, an almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for six.
Yep, the defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he converts the extra point. Great game in the works, folks, as we come to the end of the first half. 17-14, Wolfpack.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being. Each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Run inside, stop quickly.
That makes it second and 10.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Number 34 on the tackle, just in the set.
Throws it in a hurry.
And down he goes.
At about the 37-yard line.
And he's immediately tackled. Gets to around the 42. He's got an opening. They'll bring him down at the 25. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. And he's level at the 16. Tackle made at the 8. Taken down around the 4-yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
And they make the stop
right around the 4-yard line.
Tacks on the extra point.
So an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
So our score, 21-17. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Gathered in at the 6. He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Hand off up the middle. Gets out to about the 31. They bring him down in the backfield. From their own 29-yard line, third down. They come out in a 5-wide set. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands.
Well, the defense stood tall there.
Boy, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
He's tackle at the 30-yard line.
The Tigers struggled in that first half, but they've come out here in this third quarter on fire.
I would have loved to have heard the halftime speech because this head coach is a demanding head coach. Clearly, he was not happy with the first half. Whatever he said has fired his team up, and they look like a different team here in the second half.
Clemson holds a four-point lead. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Up the middle for a nice game. Look out, loose ball. Using those good hands, he scoops up the fumble. And they'll bring him down behind the line. Gets to about the 37-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
There he goes! And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a game of
He's tackled in the open field.
That makes it first and 10.
They give to the tailback. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. They got him for a loss. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. He gets rid of this one. It up and it's long enough, and he nails the long field goal. North Carolina State to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. NC State's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie, I guess, at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
They couldn't get anything going on that last drive. Clemson, up a point.
Let's go! Easy, 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 easy! Over!
Throws complete, and he's hit right away. End of the third, and we've got a tight one. 21-20, Clemson. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
Makes it third and three.
Tackle at the 48.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
And he's hit before he could go anywhere. The extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter.
There's the strike complete. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44-yard line. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34.
Tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. A score here might effectively end this one. Clemson is up by 8. And a quick throw. And he's tackled at the 30. He's knocked out of bounds. 34-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
Here's the give. And he's taken down right around the 42-yard line.
But he can't shake the defense.
Tries to buy some time, and he's sacked.
North Carolina State will take their first time out of the half. From their own 47-yard line, third down. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle.
He's tackled
around the 49-yard line. NC State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He really got a hold of that one.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The spike will stop the clock. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
Fires out to his wideout. Brought down at the 47-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield.
Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
Second down and 10 to go.
Ball on the 47.
Fires quickly to the tight end. And down he goes
at about the 45.
For it on fourth down.
They'll spread the field with five wide.
Complete. He's got room.
They'll bring him down at the 36.
A little over a minute in the game.
Makes it to the 27. The cavalry's coming. Brought down in the open field.
That makes it first and 10.
Got a receiver and he dropped it.
Terrific coverage. And when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down.
Hands it off. Gets out to about the 21.
Tackled in the open field.
He steps out at the 4-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
And this is the 14th play of the drive.
Try to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown.
Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a a game this close, who's going to crack first? Big, big conversion right here. Time is running out, and they need this one to tie it up. Five wide.
Hey, watch number 33.
He's got it for two.
Look at that sideline going crazy. Those guys are pumped. And barring a miracle, this one's headed to overtime.
North Carolina State is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game. And poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
And I think they're going to take one last shot at the end zone here. He heaves it deep. What a pick! We're going to overtime. That's the end of the fourth quarter, and we are headed to overtime.
Back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime.
And they make the stop around the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line, second down. Throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at the 12. Touchdown, Wolfpack. Splits the uprights with the extra point. From the 25-yard line, it's first down.
Let's make these babies cry.
Gets it out quickly, and they push him out at the 6. The halfback on the screen. He's taken down at the 5. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes his third and goal.
Tackle around the 1-yard line. It's fourth down, and they need 6 to keep the game alive. And they get the sack. that's going to do it for this one. Our final score, North Carolina State 35, Clemson 28. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
You just can't underestimate a team when they're your rival, and today's game proved that. And nothing stings more than losing to the one team you want to beat in overtime.
Wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.